Hello dear students, how are you getting on? Hope all of you are good. This is Shurmi Miss. Today I will be teaching you science. The topic is coordination and secretion, which is chapter 5 of your textbook. I have divided the chapter in 3 parts. Today I will start the first part of the chapter. So the first part is coordination in plants. Let's begin today's lesson. We know that animal has some specialized organ system like respiratory, digestive, nervous system, etc. by which animal can conduct information from cell to cell. But plant does not have specialized tissue or system like animal to perform their activities. To perform their activities, plants need coordination. So now we have to know that what is coordination. In simple words, we can say that coordination means a good interaction of movements or response to stimuli. Coordination is the process of correct response to a particular stimulus at correct time. So now we have to know when does plant need coordination. Plant needs coordination in different stages of their life. They need coordination in germination, growth and development, flowering, fruit formation, dormancy, etc. So, how does a plant maintain its coordination? Well, by plant hormones, which are known as phytohormone or growth regulating substance. So these plant hormones can be divided into two types. One is growth promoters, another is growth inhibitors. Growth promoters are auxins, cytokinins and gibberellins, and growth inhibitors are ethylene and abscisic acids. So dear students, let's talk about the functions of the hormones, starting with auxins. Auxin is a growth promoting hormone. It was discovered by Charles Darwin. Auxins generally exist in plumule and active growth parts of the plants. Now let's see some functions of auxins. So the first one is, auxin is synthesized at the tip of the shoot. Second one is, cell grows longer due to auxins, which help plant to grow. Third one is, if light falls on one side of the plant, auxin diffuses to shady side of shoot, and concentration of auxins promotes cell enlargement in the shady region, but the plant appears to bend towards light. So the fourth one is, cell elongation and cell differentiation towards light. Now the function of gibberellins. Gibberellins helps in growth of the stem to increase internodes. Now talk about cytokinins. Cytokinins promotes cell division, and cytokinins are present in areas of rapid cell division, for example in fruits and seeds. Cytokinin also promotes opening of stomata. Functions of abscisic acid. Abscisic acid inhibits growth or signaling to stop growth and seed germination. And abscisic acid is the reason of wilting of leaves or dropping of leaves. It also promotes closure of stomata. And the last inhibitor is ethylene. Ethylene is a growth inhibitor. It is a gaseous hormone and it promotes ripening of fruits. In the coordination of plants, we have another topic, which is phototropism. or it can be called as phototropic movements of plants. What is phototropism? Phototropism is the growth of an organism in response to a light stimulus. For better understanding, let's see an example. Okay, look at the picture of the plant shown here. The plant stem bends toward the direction from which light is coming. This movement of plants towards the light is called phototropism. Phototropism is controlled by auxins. Auxins move towards the shaded side of the plant and growth on that side of the plant increases as compared to the lighted sides. This causes the stem to bend towards the light. So students, that's all for today. Thanks for your active participation. In the next video, I will explain the other two parts of this chapter. Till then, do practice and stay safe at home. Bye bye.